it is given that we have given two vector, find the sine angle between these two vectors. Vector, let us call that vector A is equal to I plus 3j. This is vector is given. Now plus 2k, and vector B is equal to 2i minus 4j and minus k. We have find the sine angle between these two vectors, which are given two parts. So now sine theta is equal to vector A cross vector B by way vector A cross B ka magnitude. This is the result of sine theta angles. Now we have find the first of them, we have find the vector A cross B. Vector A cross vector B is equal to I j k, and this is 1, 3, 2, 2, minus 4, minus 1. This is given the conditions. Now I into these vectors is minus 3 plus 8, minus j into these vectors is minus 1, minus 4, plus k into vector by this minus 4, minus 6. We get 5i plus 5j minus 10k. Now we have find the magnitude of these vectors. Vector A cross B ka magnitude of these vectors is 5 square is 25, this 5 square is 25, this 10 square is 100. We get 20, 21, 50 under the scale. Now sine theta is equal to vector A cross B magnitude by way vector A magnitude multiply vector B magnitude. So now we take this A cross B magnitude is 150 under the square root. Now vector A magnitude is this vector A. Magnitude of this vector is, now we get I square 1, 3 square 9, 2 square 4. Now we get 14 under the square root. Vector B magnitude is 2 square 4 and this minus 4 minus this k. Now we 4 square is 60, minus 1 square 1 under the square root, this is 21 under the square root. Now we write this 150 by 14 under the square root multiply 21 under the square root. Now we solve this, we factorize 150. 150 divided by 2, 75, 5, 3. We take these as factors, 5, 5. And these right will be 5 root 6, and this will be written as 14 is 2 multiply 7 under the square root. And this 3 multiply 7 under the square root. We take this 7 2 times, we take 1 times this formula out. We get 5 root 6 by may 7 root 6. Now root 6 to 6, we get 5 upon 7. So now sine theta is the angle between them is 5 upon 7. We have find the value of a sine theta in this case. And now this say that second part of this question also say that we have find the sine theta of these given vector similar to first part. Now in questions number 15 say that find the area of a parallelogram whose adjacent sides are given. These are four parts of these questions, all are equal. Let vector A is equal to I plus 2j minus 3k. Vector B is equal to 3i minus 2j plus k. We have find the area of a parallelogram when adjacent sides are given. Area of a parallelogram when adjacent sides are given, then vector A cross B is से मैग्नीट्यूड. दिस इज द मेथड ऑफ एरिया ऑफ ए ट्रायंगल, एरिया ऑफ ए पैरेललोग्राम व्हेन एडजेसेंट साइड आर गिवन. तो नाउ वेक्टर ए क्रॉस वेक्टर बी इक्वल टू आई जे एंड के. वी हैव फाइंड दीज रिजल्ट मेनी टाइम्स. नाउ वी सॉल्व दीज रिजल्ट each questions of A cross B, B cross C, C cross A. Now we find this I into 2, this is minus 6, plus 6, after this minus. Minus J into, this cancel 1, plus 9, plus K into, this result say that minus 2 and minus 6. We get minus 4I, minus 10J and minus 8K. Now we find the magnitude of this vector A cross B. Its magnitude, it means I square in component of I is minus 4, 16, this is 100, this is 64. We get 180 under the square root. If we factorize by this, then area of triangle is 180 square in it. If you take factor of this term, you factorize this 180 by 290 by 245 by 350 by 35. So we take these two pair, we get 6, 290, 245, 3, this 2 and 3, 6, root A 15, these are the vector. If you not factorize these, we get these as a square unit area of these parallelograms. All part of vector of first diagonal is given by this. We get 3i plus j minus 2k. Second diagonal in form of vector is, we take this I minus 3j plus 4k. In this diagonal of a parallelogram are given when we find the area of a parallelogram. Area of a parallelogram, we take 1 by 2 first diagonal vector A cross B magnitude. Here the we have find this is vector A, this is vector B. We have find by this method vector A cross B, this Y method, and after this area of parallelogram 1 by 2 multiply cross product of these vectors magnitude is a square unit. It is the area of a parallelogram in when diagonals of given vector. All parts in second part are also its same. And in question number 17, he said that, question number 17 said that, find the area of a parallelogram whose vertex are given. This is the given figure of a parallelogram A, B, C, D. This is A, B, C, and D. Now it is given that 3, minus 1, 2. And 1, minus 1, 3. 4, minus 3, 1. And D coordinates is 6, minus 3, 0. These are the coordinates of a D. Now he said that we have find the area of these parallelograms. We use the parallel area of adjacent side, area of diagonals. If we take adjacent side, these are AB and BC are to its adjacent side. For adjacent side, we have find the vector of AB. It means length of AB, vector B minus vector A, and BC vector C minus this vector B. If we take the diagonal of this, now AC is the diagonal of this, and BD is the diagonal of this. Now, diagonal of AC. Diagonal for AC means vector C minus vector A, and BD means vector D minus vector B. Now for AC, component of C minus component of A with IJK we get AC, vector D minus vector component of D minus vector of B we get BD, and after this diagonal of this we use this formula for the area of a parallelogram. These are two types of questions when adjacent side using this formula, and diagonal also given. In question number 18, say that find the area of a triangle whose adjacent side represented by these curve, these vectors. Here the vector A is given by 3i plus j plus 4k, and vector b is equal to I minus j plus k. We have find the area of a triangles. Area of a triangles when side are given. Area of a triangle when adjacent side are given. So we use this formula 1/2 vector a cross vector b is a magnitude. This formula is similar to this formula. Area of a parallelogram when diagonals are a given. In board exams, we put these questions like this. When these are similar to these are also similar to these, but in these questions we have take 1/2, 1/2, but in this we take only vector A cross B is a magnitude. So now first of them we find the vector A cross B magnitude. Now vector I, J, K, and this is 3, 1, 4, 1, minus 1 and 1. We multiply by these vector, we get I into this vector 1 plus 4 minus j into this cancel 3 minus 4 plus k into this cancel minus 3 and minus 1. We get 5i, this is plus j and this is minus 4k. Now we say that vector A cross B magnitude. Now component of I square 25, J is 1 and K is 16. Under the square root we get this is 1742 under the square root. Area of A triangles. We get 1/2 A cross B magnitude means 42 under the square root. If we factorize this, if we factorize this, we have not find any factor out of this square root. This is its factors. Now we note take this. Now this is 1/√42/2 under the square root by take this for 2 square unit. It is the area of a triangle. In question 19 say that find the area of a triangle whose vertex are given. This is the triangles A, B, C. Now we are takes vertex of A is 1, 2, 4, B is 3, 1, minus 2, and C takes 4, 3, 1. Now we have discussed the area of triangles whose adjacent side are given. Now we first of find the adjacent side of these two triangles. Now, this AB and AC are two adjacent sides. If we take AB and BC are adjacent sides, if we take AC and BC is also adjacent side. So now, adjacent side of triangles. First of them, we find the triangle of side AB. It means B minus A. We use the formula x2 minus x1 I into y2 minus y1 j plus z2 into z2. 3 minus 1, 2 I, 1 minus 2, minus j, minus 2 minus 4, minus 6 k, and BC equal to 4 minus 3 I, 3 minus 1, 2 j, 1 plus 2, 3 k. These are the adjacent side of these triangle. Now we have used this formula area of a triangles. Area of triangles is AB cross BC by its magnitude multiply 1/2. It is the area of a given triangle. We have find AB and by BC by these method cross vector. This is cross vector A, this is cross vector B, and cross after this take magnitude and 1/2 it say out we take the area of a triangle.